My name is Pelton Stewart, and on behalf of the City of Vallejo, the Vallejo Sister City Commission and Association, I'd like to welcome you to our annual Japanese tea. But before we do that, I want to give honor to VCAT and Sherry Privet of it. We're going to give her a certificate of appreciation from the Northern California Sister City Association, part of Sister City International. We were able to, as a result of Sherry's work, host a conference of all the sister cities throughout Northern California and other parts of the United States. We're the first to do that, and it was a real honor to have VCAT assist us. So we'd like to present that to Sherry. And now I'd like to present a Japanese tea ceremony presented by the Perry family.
Hi, my name is Keiko Perry. I'm a member of Vallejo City Sister City Association. And I hope you're gonna enjoy this traditional Japanese tea ceremony with the help of my family, my husband Richard, and my daughter Ashlyn. I'm going to talk first about a little bit of history of Japanese tea ceremony. In China, they've been drinking tea for thousands of years, and it was introduced to Japan by Japanese Buddhist monks around 8th century. Then there was a kind of exchange students program, say, in modern way of expressing it. Japanese monks went to China and then studied architecture, literature, calligraphy, culture, and everything. Then China had very high standard of science, culture, everything. So they brought the tea culture, tea is to Japan about 8th century. And then about 12th century, a Japanese monk brought tea seeds to Japan, and Japan started to grow tea trees. And then 15th century, Japan started developing a way of tea, but still that was for high-class samurai and royal people, aristocrats. And in 16th century, there was a great tea master appeared. His name was Sen Rikyu. He established and founded tea ceremony with simple and austere way, wabicha. Since then, everything was set, and he made four principles. It is wa, kei, sei, jak. Wa means harmony, kei means respect, sei means purity, and jak means tranquility. And tea ceremony is performed with all those principles. Okay, tea bowl has a front and a back. The front is usually more decorative than back. So this tea bowl the front looks like this. And then back is nothing. So when a tea bowl or when tea was served, the tea bowl comes the front toward you, back the other way. So you receive it and hold chawan this way. Put chawan on the palm of left hand and then hold the side with right hand. So it's very secure. And you appreciate. And then you drink tea from the back, not from the front. So you turn twice clockwise. And then you drink. And then last sip, you make a little noise, like shh. And then you wipe with two fingers. And then you clean your finger with paper. After you finished your drinking tea, you turn counterclockwise twice. And you appreciate tea, the decoration and the inside. And then you just hold your tea like this. And then a server come to collect your tea bowl. So for respect, you turn your bowl front to her clockwise twice and then pass it to her. Now we're gonna start the tea ceremony.
Please enjoy your sweets.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Would you like another cup of tea?
I've had enough, thank you.
I'll conclude the tea ceremony. Would you like to admire a couple of utensils?
Yes. Please tell me what you called each utensil and a little bit about that particular utensil.
Okay, this tea caddy is hand-painted. Red lacquered with gold arabesque pattern. And the tea scoop is hand-carved by 14th Grandmaster Tantansai Sekiso of Urasenke. And the poetic name is Morning Mist.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed and learned something different from this presentation. And hope you'll have a chance to drink matcha green tea at tea ceremony. Thank you.